convention for Atlanta has just come to an end. This is ONA, Open North Association in North America, Canada. We have just summarized our Atlanta for 2018. I thank all the members and all our guests, friends, well-wishers, and their in-laws for this memorable convention. It's the first time ONA is coming to Atlanta. And also, I want to use the opportunity to congratulate my lovely wife for her support and dedication for this event. We had one of our best Nigerian DJ, also the best cook. Everything here was good, all to the glory of God, and we hope that we will continue to unify. Even a son of Okwele is going to be contesting for governorship of Connecticut. He has just finished speaking. Blessing in the name of Chukwudi Diko. So we all have our fingers crossed and we're supporting him so that we'll have the first Nigerian to be the governor of Connecticut. This will be a milestone for Okwele and for Nigeria and the whole Africa, first time in this United States of America. Thank you all for this convention. God bless you. We'll have a good time. Bye.
Chukwudi Diko reporting from Atlanta at ONA's 25th year anniversary. Can you believe it? 25 years. We started back in 1994 in White Plains, New York, and 2018 in Atlanta. 25 years of being together and celebrating one another and achieving great things. Now we're looking forward to the next 25 years of doing great things. It's always a joy to be here with my brothers and sisters from Okwele, from all around the United States of America, to come in here just to be with one another and celebrate each other and plan ahead. So we've had a great time here. We want to say a special thank you to Chief Mrs. Clifford and Cordelia Ofebu and Ike Duribe and Mrs. Bife Duribe for a fantastic hosting. Everybody's had a good time here. Wonderful time, wonderful people. I can't say more. Next year, maybe it's gonna be Houston. It's not confirmed yet, but next year it's gonna be even greater. We're lucky to have most of our young people in the house. I think on record, this is the most attended ONA convention yet. Yes. So big up to Atlanta and congratulations to the East Coast for a wonderful convention. God bless ONA, God bless Okwele, God bless Imo State, God bless Nigeria, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, my name is Professor Ike, and I'm the chairman of the Board of
Directors of the Board of Directors. So, like I was saying, we met.
We had a three-day function on Friday, where we had a meet and greet, and then on Saturday we had a normal business meeting, and then tonight we have Nigella. And I'd like to thank our brothers and sisters in Atlanta, particularly Chief and Chief Mrs. Clifford for hosting us on Friday. And then for my other brothers, Francis and Libby, also coordinating and hosting the Okwele Association. It's been a great event, as you can tell, it's been a fun and enjoyable weekend. And we will have more fun tomorrow, Sunday, where we will have an outing and the tour of the City of Atlanta as well as the park location, to show at the park. So we are very, very grateful for our folks in Atlanta and thank you so much for this time. And we look forward to the future of the association. Next year it's going to be hosted by the Rec Center. We are hoping to provide everyone with information as we can learn about our next year's meeting. So again, thank you so much, and
distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I warmly welcome you to this very special occasion.
is the 26th event of the Okwele Association in North America. My name is Akeem Richard, he came Ekwe. I'm honored, humbled to be your master for this great ceremony. Can you please give yourselves a great round of applause? Come on.
Ya wọ ọrụ federal government na state government so suppose create.
Ọ̀yà Ìjìrìmọ̀ n'Ọ̀gbẹ́lá ayé. In a short, Anambra Module, that is great jobs, always have the way to go. Bíkọ̀ Chineke nyere anyị niile aka ka ihe niile anyị bụ n'obi ka ọ gara nke ọma n'aha Jizọs. Nyere anyị aka ihe niile anyị ga-eme n'obodo a nọ. Ma ndị enyi anyị bịara ngara, biko emee any amount dị small. Biko onye ọbụla mmanya aka na-akpa were nyere Ọ̀gbẹ́lá Association aka. Onye azụ azụ ụmụ anyị na our culture, Igbo culture and Christian culture. Biko ma ihe anyị ga-eri n'obodo a, ma ihe a ga-anụ, Chineke bịa dozieere anyị ya. Mepere n'anyị aka ma anyị ga-ala ala ka anyị laa n'obiọma. Ụmụnne anyị ndị kebikọ na Atlanta, biko nye ha ogologo ndụ, biko sa gbalị ka ha ga nabata anyị nụ. Ihe ndị a ka a na-ere n'aha Jizọs.
Ladies and gentlemen, I believe we can do better. Let's give him a resounding round of applause. Yes, having solemnized this great event, the next item on my list is presentation of kola nuts. This is a very traditional ritual. For those of us who are not from Okwele, kola nuts don't speak any foreign language. It speaks our traditional Igbo language. And if you don't know what it is, after the ritual, you could just touch the tray if they pass this kola nut. It's not candy. It's not candy. It's a very significant traditional stuff that, you know, for elders, it's very significant. So to do this presentation, I'm going to invite Resource Focus Point, the president of this great association. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as I invite to the South Focus Point Chief Matthew Uzuku, the Inkyoha One of Umokodike. Put your hands together.
Thank you. Okolo na uno. Because they can any nekura ego okuda ba le mci na ego here na we dey pa na come na mai here we oje ndi isko so bin na ndo bole kai si me mai me business with na today here ak ma bolete ndi elder sign ka habia gozi odia a gozi e kai pa e pa mi shi ke na ye ndo zo de mani. So I am going to go to the but I give you a piano. Chief Ashamole, Dico Biache. Chief Medo. Well, can you hear me by Fiat? Fiat, well, I I think I feel 70, you want to get whatever. I want to go on a hair of Fiat. You get the people. Chief of Weibo, you go be ever, huh? Can you take where I can take a book or a book, Chief Sammy? My brother, I'm only 70. Come on now. Can we go over the crowd ever?
Chairman, bro, do you remember 70?
Okay, I can make a chief of women for 70. Come here, man, I'm on a year old. When you see a plant ever, not quite your piano, but yeah. You know, I mean. So, all the mark on the never you are done in here. I am empty for the day. When I need to be able to serve you to even get fair. Oh, blessing to you. Now, I can be near Chief Ashamole. He will regard him. Chief Leo.
Because now I work for you. Asọ onye wetara ọjị wetara ndụ. Ndị ụmụnne anyị wụ This is on our hand with Rajan over there. Today, I want no man. Ah, Jesus. I saw what I killed with Rajan. Rajan, man. Oh, we woke up there. Them, what can I take here, babe? I'll tell you my mind, she'll be clear. Ndị ọhaneze niile bịara nga onye na ewetara wụ sọsọ ndị okwere ka ewetara ọma ụmụnne anyị si ọnụ n'obodo obodo niile dị iche iche bụ ọhaneze ndị igbo ma ndị Enugu steeti ụmụnne anyị ndị ọzọ Abia steeti Anambra Delta steeti my Ebonyi State, America, hi. Biko Chineke, Anna Yogi, Biko Jera Yogi, Biko Jera Yomai, 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 Okwelekwe a gaa na-anọ ọkwa biko Chineke bịaguziere anyị ụmụaka nye ha amamihe ka anyị zụọ nghọta echiz anyị n'okwere n'ala igbo aha Jizọs biko Chineke kụziere anyị ọzi a ka anyị taa ya tara ahụ isi ike tara ọganihu ihe ndị a ka anyị na-ere n'aha Jizọs ọ na-anwụchiri anwụchi.
Biko nọ enwe ndụ shiri eshishi n'ekiti anyị ndị ukwu anyị na-eji aga mba anụ anyị n'ekiti ha biko bịa were ọjị maka na ọ dịghị fecha fecha ọ dịghị ofele biko nọ ndụ shiri eshishi niile mmadụ ọrụ ka agụmakpụ ndị ọhụrụ ha azụ ebe anyị mma anyị pụta anyị rekọgnaize ha ga-abịakwa ndị niile shiri eshishi. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the incoming governor of Connecticut, Biko Kwaraga! And this is Okwela is producing the next governor of Connecticut. And this is my mentor and father, Chief Ike Ehi. This man took me to Babbage for the very first time. And to the National Museum in Lagos, Nigeria. Yes, he taught me the importance of education. A round of applause for him. Yes. Any other, yes, that's my brother right there, one of the newly honored chiefs. Odiuko, Odiuko number. Yes, that's my very good brother right there. We want other title women. Okay, Umuwai, do you know what the hell you know? No, I got the agroji here, no matter how I'm America. And we're other title people. If we have other title people from other clans, please, you are also permitted to come take a piece of kola nut. While we're doing that, may I also use this great opportunity to recognize the presence of our great in-laws, our very special friends, eminent personalities here gathered. We say welcome to this very special event. A round of applause for all of you, ladies and gentlemen. You're welcome, very, very warmly welcome. Okay. Yes. While the chairman is finalizing this ritual by passing the tray of kola nuts to someone to do justice to it, may I also double up with the chairman to come and give us the opening remarks. A round of applause for the chairman one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Before we share Nakike, we have it. I have electronic applause.
Thank you. Okolo na uno. Agama so oyibo na ina. Tuzo ndi ina ba uwa ndi yuta umwai. So kahano na oyibo kana so. Agura mane iya na agena aga ana asi uwa so kwa beke ya so oyibo. Anyway, let me thank everyone for being here this evening. To be with us for the this gala night to celebrate the 25th anniversary of Okwele Association in North America. I'd like to thank Chief Ofuebu and Mr. Ike Duribe. They are our folks in Atlanta who actually have been directly hosting us. Specifically, I want to thank their wives, Chief Mrs. Ofuebu and Mrs. Bingbe Aduribe. Are they here, the two women? Chief Mrs. Ofuebu and Mrs. Bingbe Aduribe. Please stand up for a moment to be recognized and appreciated. Biko Korana Haka Maga. Thank you so much. We're not doing any high table tonight. This is a simple event that we're doing. It's late in the night, and so I won't say much. I'd like to congratulate us also for the coming Igbo Spelling Bee. This will be the fifth year we've been doing this. We started this 5 years ago. I know, Mr. Ekwe, you did make mention about your concerns about the fact that most of our kids can speak our language. But we started to do something about it 5 years ago by starting the Igbo Spelling Bee competition. Tonight will be the fifth year we've been doing this. It's, you know, just like you said, little things are, you know, necessary to try to keep our language alive. So we're doing that tonight, and I want to thank us for supporting that also. Now next year, for our youth, because we've always thought about how we can involve our youth, continually interested in what we're doing. So I proposed to the General House this afternoon in my speech that next year we're going to begin the Miss Okwele USA pageant sponsored by ONA. So people go, well, next year for Miss Okwele USA by ONA. In fact, Chairman Mutai, Okamutai, will probably, he said, also more. So maybe I go over Miss Okwele USA. Next year. So in the Utah, we prepared for next year. We were supposed to have our 25th anniversary celebration in a big way this year, but we decided to move it to next year. So we're going to have the formal celebration next year. And I would think that these pageants for Miss Ona and Mr. Ona will be major features of our event next year. So all of you here today, we really appreciate it. Chief Ashimola said, this is the biggest crowd we've ever had in a long time, and most of them are youth, our kids. So please, let's give a round of applause for our children. And tell them, you know, be prepared for next year for the pageants. And finally, I just want to say, enjoy yourselves. No long speeches. I think the next thing is dinner, correct? Yes, because the food is getting cold. Thank you so much once again. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Chief Sir Chuku Didiko. What do you call him?
Thank you. Wow. First, I want to thank the president, Chief Dr. Matthew Zuku, for giving me the honor to say a few words here. Chairman, Chief Professor He, thank you, sir. My fellow owner members, our guests, young people here, everybody, I want to say hello and welcome to the 25th anniversary of Owner in America. Thank you for being here tonight. We really appreciate your presence. I'm going to make this very, very brief because I know the schedule is very tight. But let me just take a few minutes to introduce myself to those who don't know me, and maybe reintroduce myself to some of you who already know me. When I was growing up, my late father, Chief Sir Ephraim Diko Ojikurome the First, taught me many lessons, but the one I never forget is when he said, "You never need permission from anyone to pursue your dreams and aspirations. And nothing is impossible as long as your education and training has prepared you for that position." And I took that to heart in everything I do. For too long, we have ceded the right to governance to the political, the professional politicians and their cronies. And too often, the result is not in the best common interest. So when you see something going wrong, as I have seen in my state of Connecticut, and I know I am positioned to do better than the politicians that are there right now, in the words of Robert F. Kennedy, who said, and I quote, some people see things the way they are, and they ask why. I see things the way they are not, and I ask, why not? Why not me? Why not now? See, I came here maybe 30 years ago, and I know for a fact, looking in this crowd, there are people who have been here longer than I have been here. But, you know, with all the talents and all the resources we bring to this American project, our people still opt to sit or stand on the sidelines and watch as if this is not their business. And they say, let others go do it. By the way, others that were more educated than, more qualified than, and have better resources than. You tell me, of all the subgroups in America today, is there any subgroup that is more talented, more resourceful than our subgroup? The answer is no.
So why are we so apathetic in the most important pursuit of all that decides everything from education to our welfare to our retirement and everything that concerns us as a people? So, ladies and gentlemen, my brothers and sisters, I am happy to tell you that 3 months ago, I got into the race to seek the highest office in my state, the governorship of the great state of Connecticut. In these three months, it's been a journey and a lot of sacrifices. I want to thank my beautiful wife, Lady Ann Deco. I couldn't be doing this without her. I want to thank our three lovely kids, Adeze, Chuck Jr. and Ike. These 3 months has been a lot of sacrifices, away from the family, away from my business, away from my life. But I'm happy to do it because it's my passion and I believe in what I'm doing. So we are doing what has to be done. I am running as an independent candidate in the race. Ultimately, it's going to be a three-way race with the Republicans, Democrats, and God willing, myself. The immediate task before me now is to get on the ballot. In Connecticut, according to the law, to get on the ballot as an independent candidate, I need to satisfy the statutory requirement of 7,500 signatures. Right now, I'm happy to tell you that my team and I, of very dedicated folks, have been working around the clock, and we are within a good shot of making it to the ballot. Of that 7,500, we are in excess of 6,000 right now, and we have about 3 weeks to go. If we can achieve that result, that would be a history. That would be history in the making, because nobody in the history of Connecticut on the platform of an independent party has succeeded in achieving that. So we are on the threshold of history in Connecticut, and I feel in my heart we're already there, by the way. Yes. I feel very confident because impossible is nothing. Yes. A lot of people, when I got into this race, some of them said, "Are you crazy? With everything you're doing, you want to run for governorship?" And I said to them, "You just watch. Because when you tell me you can't do this, that's when I get fired up. And I want to show you that impossible is nothing." So, I want to thank everybody here for your support and your encouragement. Although most of you are far away from Connecticut, but I feel your prayers. Those who call me, who send me messages. Last week, my campaign had a very successful fundraiser. Some of you came down. Robert Onye, which is here, Oduko One, please give him a round of applause. He drove all the way from Illinois and showed up in Connecticut with his two boys. Man, I tell you, that was the highlight of the night. And turned around and drove back to Illinois like with 3 hours sleep. It was there physically. Chris Unamka drove from Massachusetts. A lot of you, the president was and his wife were coming from Maryland, but had car problems, as did Chibemedo. And so many of you called. And since then, a lot of you, and we truly appreciate this, a lot of you have sent us donations, contributions in the mail. We really appreciate it. It means a lot. And when I say that, believe me, because for 3 months, this campaign has been self-funded. My daughter never ceases to remind me, say, "Daddy, make sure we're not broke." But by grace of God, we're not gonna go broke because God takes care of us. And the cause we're fighting for is the right one. It's the right one because we know we can do better. You look at what is going on in America today and you got to ask yourself, why? Why in the midst of the greatest prosperity, Wall Street, NASDAQ, Dow, S&P 500, Russell 2000, everybody keeps saying America is swimming in cash. Corporate America is declaring billions after billions every week. And then you look on Main Street and you see businesses closing. You see kids programs getting cut. Elderly programs getting cut. People are becoming, for the first time since 1929, the year of the Great Depression, homelessness in America has gone up by 1.5%. Poverty rate is inching up. And yet, you look around and they keep talking about all these billions being made in corporate America. And it's not right. Something is not right somewhere. So we have to fight. We fight for the working class, we fight for the middle class, we fight for the masses to make a change. And by God's grace, we will. This is my passion. This is my passion. And I thank everybody for coming along with the ride in whatever way, with your prayers, with your calls. Please keep it coming. And above all, we're going to make history by God's grace. So stay tuned. For some of you who like to follow my campaign, go to www.chuckdicoforgovernor.com. And of course, many of you follow me on Facebook. Just Chukwudi Diko, Diko for Connecticut Governor. You can follow our progress, see what we're doing. I almost did not make it here today because I was conflicted. I told my wife, how do I leave my team back in Connecticut and I'm here when every day right now is critical to the campaign? But I said, this is the 25th anniversary. I am not going to miss it. And by the way, I might be wrong, but I don't think I am. I might be the only member of ONA who has never missed any convention. I have a perfect attendance record of 25 years. From 1994 in White Plains to 2018 in Atlanta, I have never missed a convention. So I'm not going to let my record, you know, get broken at the start. So here I am, and I'm glad I'm here. Nothing beats being among you beautiful people. Better than a campaign, by the way, I got to tell you that. So thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity, and God bless you all. Thank you.
¡Vamos! Yeah.
That was awesome.
That was been for the past 4 or 5 years. And the purpose is to help our children understand our culture. We started with a spelling B. We call it a spelling B. That means they spell the word in Igbo language and tell you the meaning. They graduated from that stage. Now we're moving to Asusibo itself. That means speaking the language in Igbo. Right? So we made it a little bit tougher this time. You can see the number has reduced because it's getting tougher. But the other thing is, you parents do not do your work. Right? If you don't do your work, you're supposed to help them study the material. Look at the number we have. Right? These are very dedicated. And they're going to win prizes today and take home and go shopping on Monday. Right? So this is how we do it. This time we have materials in English language. They will pick and give it to us. We tell them what they picked. And they have to say that in Igbo language. Alright? They pick, it's going to say in English. And they have to tell us what that means in Igbo language. Are you all ready? Now we have them in grades. We have first to the fourth grades, they are not here. Fifth to the eighth grade, one is dropping out. So now we have 9 to the 12th graders. Right? So these kids are dedicated. And they are willing to win the prize tonight. Are you all ready? Alright, so you're gonna pick. Right? You close your eyes, you pick one. And we're going to tell you what you think in English language. Alright? So you tell us what that means in Igbo language. Alright. So give a applause to this case, please. Alright, tell us your name.
My name is Chidi Onyewuchi.
Chidi Onyewuchi. And tell us your name.
Ahambo Ikechukwu Obiko.
Chidi, close your eyes and pick a paper. Chidi, are you ready? Chidi, you pick in English. I don't like this. Can you tell us what it is in Igbo?
Idea adihi mma.
This is what you pick in English. Here is the money.
Lekwa ego. Lekwa ego.
How to pronounce it. That is very important, how you say it. Right? So be careful how you say it. It's not matters. Do you understand?
Igotara.
Yeah.
Eagle, you pick seat. Seat. Like a chair. Seat.
Oche.
Oche.
Okay, you pick, please write it down. Please write it down.
Because they're too young.
Because you pick books. Books. Okay, Chi, you pick books. Books.
Akuko.
Raika, you pick good morning. Good morning.
Utu Toma.
Ladies and gentlemen, give me a round of applause to this guy. So we have a draw, right? Each one of you came first. So you're going to share the prize. Congratulations. Give me a round of applause, please. All right, well, no, we don't have first graders here. Do we? First grade? Four. Come here. You guys are done. What's your name?
Obetuku.
Obetuku. Okay. Right. You're gonna pick, right? Okay, Obetuku, you pick. Here is the money. Okay, to which one you pick, I agree. I agree. Another one. Okay, this time you pick luggage. Okay, another one. This time you pick, I have cold. I have cold. Okay, good afternoon. But I want that to be the last one. You pick aeroplane.
Aeroplane.
Thank you. Give a round of applause for this game, man. Okay, yeah, I think we've come to the... We've come to the end of this program. He's only participating in that grade. So he gets a prize also. Next time, please encourage your kids to participate. Right? The emails were sent to the parents. You're supposed to get them out and give to the kids. So I hold the parents accountable for not, you know, helping the kids with this material. So next time, we're going to do better than this. All right? So clap for all these kids, please. Clap for them.
Just listen with your eyes, your ears, your nose, your legs. By 12 noon, there's this transit bus that is going to pick all of us from Hilton. 12 noon exactly. Yes, at Hilton. There's 12:15. The transit bus is going to move to Comfort soon. 12:15. Please put on your lipstick, your eye, whatever, whatever. Why? Carry up and go for before that time. Comfort suit, 12:15. No African time. The tour is taking us to downtown Atlanta. But before
benyama koma so wadi ama benia di ogi adi I don't like my rapper so we could be the feel now I'm not go come tonight I said you could have go mama go do and I give you go be the sika na mona mo ma go the cow ya we be am go ma go go the get the sika go so I will show ya be ya mo back up la you so the shit I can see come me for the go ni ma go da kaso be you go mama you sika go you go right my short is see I go it is me kem kase go I don't call you.